Hey there everybody, redxparasite here, and welcome back to Let's Play Metroid Prime 2. In the last episode, we picked up some more items, we picked up some items, we kept working on collecting Sky Temple keys, now we're gonna keep doing just that. I've realized that I haven't actually made a super crystal just yet. So we're gonna start off this episode by doing that. So this actually completes all of the research section of our logbook. So this is the last thing. Super crystal. Crystal's energy draws Ings into destructive field. When charged with light and dark energy at once, the crystal becomes a beacon to Ing. They're compelled to approach it despite the deadly field of energy it emits. And this is pretty much the same exact thing. So, now that we have that out of the way, we have a train wreck of an intro because good intros are overrated. We are going to head here to the feeding pit. And if we go and take a little dip here, you can see a lot easier with the dark visor under the water here. You need to, could have sworn it was like around this area. Maybe it's right here? I'm not crazy. Oh, there it is. Okay. There is just a power bomb expansion just kind of sitting here. So, obviously impossible to get without the light suit. Actually, fun fact about that. You can't actually even go into the dark water if you don't have the light suit. The game just straight up won't let you. Because there's actually an invisible floor over. Let's see. I don't want to go this way. This is the long way around. But there is actually an invisible floor that's just kind of over the dark water until you get the light suit. So if you somehow manage to get under it, you'll actually be stuck there because you can't get out, because it also serves as like a ceiling. So yeah, just don't do that, because it's not advisable. But now that we have that power bomb expansion, we actually want to head in this direction. I believe there are, I want to say, two keys in Dark Agon. One of them is actually in this room. So if you see, there's a lot of platforms here, and you can ride the platforms, or you can kind of screw attack across. I have had some difficulties actually screw attacking across this before for whatever reason, but in any case, the key that we are looking for is here, so pick that up. Then we're gonna drop down to the lower level here, and take this super missile door. If we scan this, we'll see that we can break this with not power bombs. You just need regular bombs. I did not actually need to use a power bomb there, but we got an instant on morph too. Oh, so yeah, the deal with Phazon is actually when you first step into it, it starts damaging you like fairly slowly. It's only after you actually stay in constant contact with it for a while that it will become a problem. So now I believe we don't have any more business in the temple, nor in that area of the dark world, so I think we want to head towards the dueling range. We want to head in that direction, so let's jump down jump down here. And there should be an expansion in this room that we were not able to get before because we did not have the spider ball. So we need to hit this bomb slot, it will rotate it, the expansion is at the bottom. We just fall down. Boom. And then we'll have to hit the bomb slot again to turn this back around. So actually we got past 200 missiles in the last episode as well. And the maximum in this game is 255. So we still have 8 more packs to go. So we're just gonna ignore these Warrior Ing here. Don't really pose much of a threat to us at this point. So in this room, they're inglets. The door's blocked, so you may be wondering, like, what's the point of, you know, this room? But there's a missile expansion that's tucked under the ledge here. So it's fairly cleverly hidden. So now that we have that, I believe that covers all of the expansions that we have left in the Dark World. So we're going to want to head back to the Light World, but... not before we pick up a key, so we have to make our way actually back to the reactor area, so have to boost quickly through here. So I'm trying to think. Yeah, I don't think there are any other Sky Temple keys for Agon other than the ones that we got. So we'll just screw attack over this way. And actually managed to land on that. I didn't think that I was gonna land on it, but you know, I'll say that, you know, I totally meant to do that. It's the official story and I'm sticking with it. Okay, yeah, because we got the one that's in here. And I don't know why I tried to do that, but if I zoom out and look at the map here, you know, there aren't any keys that are in any of these areas of the map. It's just the battleground, and then there's one in the Dark Oasis as well. And the reason that I kind of saved that one for last was, there's a portal right in that room, so we can just use that to return to the Light World quickly. So, you know, it's a convenient thing to end with. So in order to get to this key, there's actually a wall here that, you know, I think we did scan it a previous time that we were here, and we need to powerbomb that. And if we go down into the water here, here's the pod, or I get, you know, the flying ink cache, and that should be it for everything in the Agon area. So I believe, oh great, there's those stalactites on the ceiling are a bit of a nuisance. They're kind of hard to see. I think this is an ammo station here. Yeah. I didn't stop by it before. You haven't really been around this area in the Dark World for a while now, so it's kind of why. So, now we're just gonna... Oh, hey, we hit the door, too. Let's take this portal and get out of here. So, now that we're back in the Light World, we need to go to Torvus. So, this is not the fastest way to do that. I've been having a lot of those times where, like, I know the door that I want to go through, but for whatever reason, I just go through the wrong door. So let's see. We can head through the upper door here. So instead of going back to Temple Grounds, we're just going to take the elevator directly to Torvus. That'll actually spit us out in a nice place for us. So, and one of the nice things about stopping by that ammo station is now you can see how lovely our beam ammo gauges look now that we have all of the beam ammo expansions. So, I'm going to ignore you guys because I don't like you. You've been a minor nuisance to me in the past. Nope, okay, that's not how you jump up to a ledge. Hey, they gave me a little boost. That was nice of them. Alright, so we're gonna head through this portal room. And we're almost at the elevator. Let's see if I can get this in two. Yeah. So, Torvus, I will soon be in you. Okay, so now that we are here in Torvus, we're at the bottom of the temple, and we want to head for Torvus Grove first. There are a couple of expansions in that neck of the woods that we can get. We have some seed bursters. Shoot. Yeah, I think that's what they are. If I got that wrong, then excuse me, but... yeah, so this area, of course you guys would. So actually, you know what, since we're full on ammo, let's try out our fancy new sonic boom. And it did not seem to work. Yeah, no, we definitely used it. There we go. Yeah, that's pretty nice. Although, you know, as I've said before, very costly. So hit you, you freeze, and just take you out. Let's try to get some of that ammo back. Luckily, there are a lot of crates in this particular room. That's not it, right? Yeah. Okay, there are two more over here. Okay, so one of these legs, this one, is weakened. So if we lay a power bomb, we can actually bring this entire structure here down. Oh, wait, is there another one that I missed? Ah, of course there is. Okay, so we have to hit both of them. And then it will collapse and somehow break open that wall. That animation is not very convincing. But, you know what, it's a missile expansion, so I'll take it. Okay, so we're going to head to the room with the portal here. And we're actually not here for the portal. You can see there's a platform that's kind of floating back and forth. This particular energy tank... can be a bit tricky trying to land on the platform, but at the very least, the only difficult part is actually getting onto the platform. You know, screw attacking back is pretty easy because the target area is a lot bigger and doesn't move. So now that we have that, we want to head to Forgotten Bridge, so we should take this boost ball ramp. Ah, I kind of messed that up. pretty sure you can get up this one in just two boosts. So we'll try to get some more ammo back. And luckily, our ammo reserves are a lot bigger, so I don't have to worry about being as low on ammo, but... in any case, we'll just make our way through here. And these guys are actually still here. I think this is one of the few rooms that actually does not change, you know, what enemies show up in it, depending on where you go. So, we kind of have a bit of an option of what we want to do here. I guess I'll go and get these ones first. So we actually have not been to this room in the light world. This is where we got the boost ball in the dark world. But in order to get the upgrades here, I think you need the spider ball at the very least. I want to say the screw attack is also required, but yeah, it just wasn't worth it for us to come into this area until, you know, now. So, this is a bit of a puzzle here. Just have to hit these bomb slots. It rotates those around, and then we can get this expansion. I think it's on the right side, yeah. So, now that we have that, get to go and get probably one of the most annoying upgrades in the game. It's not an upgrade, but expansion. One, Dark Pirate Commandos can show up in this room. That's always, you know. Oh, that was actually super efficient. But in addition to Dark Pirate Commandos being able to show up in this room, we have a lengthy, and I do say lengthy, I'm not, you know, exaggerating. We have a lengthy spider ball track here. So you have to boost in order to get up to it. But what makes this particularly fun, and we'll see it soon, is there's a sporb right there, and unfortunately you can't do anything to the sporb. You know, you can see I tried to use a power bomb on it, and you can't do anything to it until until it comes out and tries to attack you. So basically, this thing will try to keep attacking you over and over again. And as you can see, I was trying to do this part, but it kept hitting me. I think there are two of them in this particular course, which is just the worst. But I don't know what I was going to say there, but yeah, it's just, it can knock you off, like, and when I say, you know, knock you off, I don't just mean, like, what happened to me. It can just knock you off the track entirely, which is, you know, a major pain. So, usually I would recommend trying to take care of them like that if you can, because otherwise you're in for a world of hurt. So, unfortunately, you just have to be patient with this one, really. It's just a lot of waiting. Actually, yeah, you don't need the, screw attack. All you need is the spider ball. And that actually nets us our very last energy tank of the game here. So, pretty neat. We have all the energy, all the ammo, all the upgrades, and now all we lack is just one power bomb and a few missile expansions, so we're closing in on 100%. Yeah, see, we're at 94% of the scans and 94% of the items. How about that? So, now we're going to want to take the portal here and go to the Dark World. Because we have some things to do there. So, once we get to the Dark World, there's a powerbomb door here. We could have done this a little bit sooner, but it requires a lot of powerbomb ammo to get this particular expansion, so that's why I waited to do this. We've got a Dark Phagus here, and you can actually kind of see it behind the wall, but if we lay a powerbomb, here is the last powerbomb expansion, so we're at 10 out of 10 is the max for those, and we're going to open up this door as well. You can choose to not open this door, but there is a key here in this room, like a Sky Temple key, so in order to pick that up in an expedient manner, we'll want to open that. So it's actually kind of close to where the missile was in the Light World here. But here's that missile expansion. And so with that, it's all we can do in this particular area of the Dark World. So we're just going to actually head straight back for that portal and return to the Light World. It's kind of a shame that they restrict you from moving around in the Dark World so much. Because usually the Dark World areas are specific regions, and then they'll, you know, just disconnect them so that you have to use certain portals to get into certain ones. So, now that we're here, we actually want to head towards the Hydrodynamo Station, so the Undertemple area. We can actually just screw attack across this now. Yeah, pretty convenient. And hopefully they won't appear. Of course. I feel like I've had the Dark Pirate Commandos show up more in this playthrough than they usually do when I'm playing. It's not all that likely. I think it's only like about a 50% chance. I know I don't have really good evidence in this particular playthrough, but just believe me when I say they usually do not show up that much. So, we'll finally make our way to the Undertemple. So, I'm trying to think. I believe the one key that we got up here in the Poison Bog is the only one in the top area here. So, let's see, we're gonna need to head down. I guess first things first, we can go here. There is an expansion, it's a missile, that you need the Annihilator Beam in order to access. And we have that, you know. Finally. There's also a portal in this room too, and I think that might be the one that we want to use. Okay, Okay, so this particular puzzle, we're going to need to change the direction of the current flow so that we can actually get up, and we're going to have the bomb physics again. Ah, did not get quite enough height off of that. It's actually interesting. You can go through, like, left to right and up and down here, because there's kind of some grates there, but they're hard to see. And they prevent you from, you know, going from falling through the other direction. So actually, yeah, this one's not timed at all, which is nice. But, I mean, it's pretty simple. Just gotta make sure that you don't fall down, like, right here before you want to. And then, I'm gonna double check and see. So the one that we wanna actually go to the... pretty sure it's the dungeon, so... let's head back to the left, and I guess I'll find out soon if I'm wrong. Nope, that's not what I wanted to do. And we have Grenchlers in here, which is wonderful. Oh yeah, no, yeah, this definitely is the one, because I saw the keeper and not back in the water again. Can't see. Yeah, so here's the keeper. So I guessed right. Yeah, I found Carmen Sandiego. Okay, so what we need to do is jump down in here, and this one is particularly impossible to get without the light suit, but we have another creature. This is a watch drone, a rogue sentry mechanoid, indestructible but irritated by bright light. Target can be herded out of place by exposing it to light. Watch drones were built by the Luminoth to guard key areas and hinder Ing armies. Most of these units have betrayed their masters and now serve the Ing. Watch drones are indestructible and reluctant to move, but can be forced into quitting their posts by exposing them to bright, pure light. Once the light fades, the mechanoid will return to its original resting site. So, you can shoot the beacons above them to make them move. A little tip is if you shoot them with a power beam, they will actually go out faster, like the beacons. They will go out faster than if you shoot them with the light beam or the annihilator beam. So, let's see, should have the thing here. Basically, if you don't shoot them with the light beam or the annihilator beam in this area, those watch drones will be back in place by the time that you get back. At least I think the second one will. So it is beneficial to... yeah, see, this one's just starting to go out now. No! Oh, hey, I got out. So... let's see, now that we've done that, I'm going to take a look at our map here. Yeah, I think we just want to head back to the light world. It's going to be easier for us to navigate there. Yeah, I wish it were easier to navigate in the dark world, but it's just not. Okay, so... we actually need to head to, like, the very bottom to pick up something. So I'm gonna head there. Oops. Yeah, this one in particular, we actually kind of saw it. Earlier, but couldn't do anything about it because we didn't have this particular upgrade. Because we need this crew attack in order to get it. So I'm just gonna head to this portal. get that. So, here's the wall. Yep, okay, I didn't think I had a really good angle for that. Oh, that didn't work. So we can wall jump again. So none of the wall jump surfaces in the game are actually spread out far enough to show this off, but you can actually screw attack in between wall jumps. So if they spread them out more, you could basically do a wall jump, screw attack like twice, and then wall jump again. I don't think any of the surfaces in this game are far enough apart to allow for that. You can do it in Prime 3, but just not in this game. Oops. I messed that up. So, I think our business here in Torvus is done. Save for, one more thing. Just gonna stock up on some more ammo here. Using the annihilator beam on hidelings is really great for replenishing your ammo, as you can probably see with what what just happened there. So now we want to make our way to the training chamber, because we're actually going to take this elevator, and that's going to take us to Sanctuary, where we can get the remainder of the keys. But I actually realized that I've been going for about 30 minutes, which is a lot longer than I usually make these episodes, so I'm going to cut off the episode here, and we'll do that in the next episode. So thank you very much for watching this episode of Let's Play Metroid Prime 2. I've been redxparasite, signing out.